Good afternoon, everyone. Making sure we're unmuted. Mm-hmm. Welcome to Trail Talk. Man, I'm so glad you could join us today. We're pretty excited to have our guest, Matt Axton, with us. The name Axton might ring a bell. And this is one of your guitar players.
Taylor Cropp.
Mm-hmm. Okay, very good. Taylor Cropp. Anyway, he has some other guys with him too, but evidently they're staying off camera for this. Okay. I don't know if he just thought they'd look better off camera. I know, I'm just playing.
They got this faces for radio.
Yeah. So anyway, we're very glad you could join us today. So if the name Axton rings a bell, it's because, Matt, you're related to Hoyt Axton, yes. Correct?
One of his favorite kids.
One of his favorite kids. Okay. And so what brings you to Duncan? You are not from Duncan.
California boys, all of us.
Okay.
And, basically, we came out and did a little tour out to Nashville and back and did some stops in Oklahoma. Thought we had to retread the family grounds, and now we're doing our last little stop here in Duncan.
Last little stop, and the Chisholm Trail Heritage Center gets to be one of the places they pick. We're super excited about this. So to kick us off, Matt and Taylor are going to do a few songs, and then we'll come back and talk after all that's done. So enjoy.
All right, so we're going to do a little legacy tour on these songs right now. I will do one of mine, then we'll do one of my pappies and one of my grandma's. And we'll show you the whole Axton songbook. One foul swoop. Pretty amazing. This is a very apropos for this area right here. We're going to do sort of a gunfighter ballad tune called Bad Moon.
Give us a way under the light, a bad moon.
train of going here. My grandmother, who lived here in Duncan, Oklahoma for a little bit, this is where my dad was born. So obviously my grandma had to live here at some point. It's just science right there. But she wrote a couple of tunes back in the day. One was a big hit for a guy named Elvis Presley. She happened to write Elvis's first million-selling hit called Heartbreak Hotel. I'm going to do a nice little mellow version of it for you guys right now. So thank you very much. Some big songs that some of you guys might know. Should be in the history books around here, I think. The biggest one was a song about Jeremiah was a bullfrog. That was the biggest one. But we're not going to do that one today. We're going to keep you back coming for more next time. We want you to let us come back to town again someday. You know? So we're going to do one of his biggest hits, his individual hits on the country charts. This one's called Bony Fingers. Wrote this with a beautiful lady named Renee Armand, who's still up there in Nashville playing tons of music. So music lives forever, so the musicians, no way, right? Bony Fingers. Lost my job and I feel a little older. Car won't run and the love's grown colder. Maybe things will get a little better in the morning. Maybe things will get a little better. Well, the clothes breaking my heart. Old dang place is falling apart. Maybe things will get a little better in the morning. Maybe things will get a little better. Work your fingers to the bone. What do you get? Woo-hoo! Bony fingers. Bony fingers. Well, now I've been broke as long as I remember. I get a little money and I got a running spender. When I try to save it, pretty woman, girl, then take it safe. Maybe things will get a little better in the morning. Maybe things will get a little better. Work your fingers to the bone. What do you get? Woo-hoo! Bony fingers. Bony fingers. Take it away. Beautiful Lake Tahoe, California.
Okay.
The mountains there. So my dad, the way it would work, he would do his Los Angeles stuff for movies and TV and some music, Nashville for the touring. My grandma lived out there. And they'd always have like a third place to go, you know, center himself and be inspired. And he did it out in Colorado, up in Oregon, then he landed in Tahoe.
Okay.
That's where I was born.
I see. Okay. So you grew up with country music. Did you love country music?
Well, I grew up just in all kinds of music. My mom was my dad's piano player in the band / music supervisor, and she's a classically trained piano master.
Oh, wow.
So I got that on one side, then I got my country bumpkin dad on the other. So somewhere in the middle.
Yeah.
And my dad, you know, he had folk hits, he had country hits, but his biggest ones were rock hits. So he was sort of all over the genre map as well. So right. I always had that love for all things art. Yes,
so do you have siblings?
I do. I'm my mom's only kid, but my dad has three other kids, much older. They were around in the heyday. I came later.
Oh, okay.
Mellow time.
What are they involved in music business?
They all tried at some point to do it. You know, my sister did the acting thing for a long time. Now she's a very happy school teacher in Portland, Oregon.
Uh-huh.
And I had a brother who tried to do the music stuff forever, you know, but I'm the only one that had music for both sides. So
Right. That kind of boosted your...
Yeah, exactly. Gave me a focus.
There you go.
I couldn't escape it if I tried.
Yeah. So are you like trained musically? Did you go to
school of hard knocks?
Uh-huh.
That's it. And like I said, just being around so much music and being exposed to it. I mean, I was in band in high school, I played trombone, so there's some music there,
but
it's more just sit down with the guitar and see what comes out from here and up here and, you know, make it line up.
And you write songs?
Yep, I got the Axton curse. I got way too many songs. Some of them are good, though, I swear. That first one was awesome.
The first one was very good. I love that song. Yeah. So Was that something that you always did? Did you always kind of try to write verses out? Or?
Well, I remember as a kid, you know, because I went on tour with my dad, I obviously had the vision of being on stage and being a musician that way. So I always tried to write little songs when I was a kid and sort of fell out of it. And I was more into sports. I was supposed to go to OU for football. Ah. I did a whole thing, went out there and decided to stay in California for love. Wow. The love faded, but...
But OU football, I mean, we had a rough Saturday, but yeah, we live on.
Yeah, my cousin was very depressed.
So you stayed in California.
Yeah, so been out there sort of doing the West Coast thing and just making a living as a grinding as a singer-songwriter. Mm-hmm. person. And then moved down to LA a couple years ago and met all these guys. And now we're sort of just getting the ball rolling and playing as much music as we can.
Right.
In the right order, the right notes.
Probably very,
very important. Yes.
There's someone with an ear who's always going to pick something up, right? Yeah, not wouldn't be me, but I just enjoyed watching you play. That was fun. So you said your grandma lived here in Duncan when your dad was born. But do you know why she was here in Duncan?
I know she was a teacher, so I think she was working at one of the schools. And she always sort of moonlighted as a press PR person as well. And that was her connection to Elvis. She was doing press PR for Hank Snow, who was the king of country western music at that time.
Right.
And that's who Elvis was sort of hopped on the bill with and eventually went to the stratosphere.
Right, yeah.
But my dad, they lived all over Oklahoma. Truthfully, my grandfather lived in Broken Bow forever. And then I still have family in Norman and Ada.
Okay.
So there's still accents, pockets out there.
So, was your grandma did you call her grandma? Am I calling her again?
Yeah, Mama May was her name.
Mama May.
Everybody
okay. Well, so was she like a prolific writer or was she, I mean, she just have some that made it? I mean, I don't know very much. I'm kind of curious.
So she did, I mean, back then it was sort of like a volume thing, right? Just write as much as you could and see what stuck. And there wasn't many women in the songwriting industry, especially in like country and rock and stuff. So mm-hmm. she was definitely sort of at the forefront of that in a lot of ways. And it was her side gig. So she was, you know, focusing on that while also trying to raise kids and be a school teacher and do all that stuff.
Yeah.
But she was just tenacious about that stuff. And so she does have a very extensive catalog, mm-hmm. but Heartbreak Hotel was obviously the biggest one by far that did anything.
Right.
And my dad saw how much fun my grandma and Elvis were having in the living room writing tunes. He's like, I want to do that, and made his way to San Francisco, and the rest is sort of history.
Very good. So you went to Nashville. Mm-hmm. Were you when a singer-songwriter band, when you're on the West Coast and you go to Nashville, are there connections you're hoping to make, or is it just part of a tour or like how does that work?
It's a mix of those things, right? It's about, you know, just sort of spreading music, number one, right? That's always the forefront.
Right.
But getting out to a new area that is very music centered, like Nashville is, right? It's a music city.
Mm-hmm.
There's just so many, and it's even though it's a very country music center, there's still a lot of just other talented kinds of musicians out there. And they really, you find the little pockets where they'll sort of like the Americana root stuff that we do more
mm-hmm.
of that.
Mm-hmm.
So we can do country. We always mix in a little country flavor, but we like to keep it pretty eclectic.
Right.
Which we call Americana.
Americana.
Yeah.
You know, it's kind of catchy. That's a catchy, kind of catchy. That's the thing. Yeah. We just had a photographer whose art was she was our featured artist for a few months, and she called her show Americana. Maybe it's kind of a thing right these days.
Yeah, it's easy umbrella term.
Hey, there you go. Well, it's probably really fun music and it connects you to your roots and, you know, all of those things.
Yeah.
So do you have music that is available for people to buy?
Yeah, on all the platforms, you just go to Matt Axton. Right now we only have the first single out, which is Blue Sky Rain, and it has official music video and everything that we did. So it's our first big push, but like I said, I have the Axton curse and there's just 300 songs waiting for the floodgates to open. So stuff's just going to be coming like crazy. And basically with these guys, after you get on tour together, you spend a few weeks where you live in, you know, back to back and you're living in a band together, right. You sort of get very tight artistically. So we'll probably hop in the studio very soon and get some of these more country Americana rocky stuff down so everyone can enjoy.
Very nice. So do you have a lot of performances that you do just normally? And is this like your career?
Yes. Well, I'm all in. I got no fallback.
Nope. Okay.
Me and a guitar.
Okay.
But that's why I went to LA, because there's a lot of people, like-minded people that make music their main source of income and their livelihood and their life. And instead of stuck with these guys, and this is our first official tour out here, anything past the West Coast, and it's just been great, not only checking out new places, but meeting great new people. And like you talked about, the networking part is huge as far as being an independent traveling musician. You just have to, you know, support and meet other people that are on the same path as you.
Right. So is that, like, do you do your own business stuff?
Yes, that's the independent part.
Right. So is that kind of a grind? I mean, it seems like you have to be up and meeting and always ready to just impress people and all of that.
Well, there's all the behind the scenes stuff, you know, see like all the web development and the t-shirts and the, you know, the website and the social media and all those little things that
you need to do, and
coordinating all that stuff. So the key is, you know, just getting a good small team around you where everyone's really focused, and you have to really plan your steps out. You know, you really have to know, like, all right, oh, I'd love to just go on the Tonight Show and be super famous. Yay. But you're like, okay, to get there, when they do call, you want to have all your ducks in a row so that everything's prepared and ready. And, you know, that's the grind, but it is a part of it. And it's rewarding when it all lines up and you get to do stuff like this.
Right. So do you, are there like classes or people who help teach artists like yourself how to do that kind of thing? I've talked to artists who paint and they have, or create other things, and they've told me about, like, there are people who take the time and teach and kind of pass those skills along, because, I mean, my husband's pretty good with all the money stuff, but I'm not. And so it's like, it's not everybody is going to be good handling that sort of thing.
No, that's the thing, putting the people in the right position.
Yeah.
Forward is really the most important thing you can do, especially as an artist, right?
Because nothing's
set. There's no set path. You sort of have to find it as you go.
Right.
But there are people that will do, you know, that will show you some of the whys and hows to do it. But reality, the landscape is moving so much with sort of how everything's transitioned to social media and to digital age. It's not that traditional, like, get a record deal and all of a sudden you're on the radio. It's just not working that way.
Yeah.
Which is good. I mean, so many more people have exposure and chances to be heard and seen like they didn't have before. But at the same time, it's a very saturated pool now.
Right.
So you got to really stand out. For me, it's been more connecting with my dad's old band members and the people that sort of went through that, the 60s and 70s grind of the musicians that I think made the best music, really, that era, in the mid-50s or the early 70s, everything just lined up well.
Right.
So picking their brains, how they did it, you know, what we learned, you know, all the little things, you know, when you have to jam a bunch of guys in the room, you gotta realize that you know where the laundry is and stuff.
Yeah. So I don't know, do you think that having all the social media and all those platforms, do you like that more than, I mean, because you've been a singer-songwriter for a long time, way before that was a thing. Do you like it better like this?
So in my mind, it's a tool. You use it as that. You know, it's a networking tool. It's a way to meet people you never would have met, expose people to music that would never have heard it.
Mm-hmm.
I can get a fan of the Far Side of Sweden if I want to, which is amazing.
Right. Yeah.
So it's definitely a necessary thing. And if you use it right and don't get trapped in it, then I think it's totally an important and necessary piece of being a professional musical puzzle.
Right, yeah, I can see that. So what's been your favorite thing on this trip so far?
This is pretty awesome. I mean, we didn't get to check out the whole museum, but
right,
I got to catch some frozen and country music. I'm like,
Chisholm Trail Heritage Center, you need to come see us too.
Yes,
yeah.
Nashville is great just because it's, you know, walking down Broadway, even though it is a different kind of music maybe than we'd be playing, but just to hear bands coming out of like 20 doors at one time, you sort of feels, because LA is very artistic, but it doesn't have anything like that, you know, like a center like that of music. So that was great. And we got to meet tons of great people and do some like picking parties and go to some late night shows and just squeeze as much as we could into that.
Very fun. Very fun. Well, I'm so glad you got to come to Duncan. I'm glad you stopped by here, and you're going to have to go see the mural.
Yeah, we'll check it out.
That'll be a lot of fun. Do you happen to have one more song you could play for us?
Let's do one more song.
I think that'd be a fun way to kind of, you know.
Yeah, end it off, carry on top.
Yeah, so when you finish singing, I'll come back on and we'll
say the bye-bye.
So, yeah. All right. One more time, Matt Axton and Taylor Croft.
Okay, we're going to do a tune on My Pappy Road. It's a big hit for a band called Three Dog Night. Not the one about a frog, it's a different one. Although this one does say Oklahoma in the lyrics, so you guys might know this. I've never been to Spain.
Do it
so madaxton.com is my official site that has sort of links to all that stuff and buy t-shirts and CDs and stickers, whatever you guys want on there. But check out Matt Axton on all the streaming
performances, anything like that.
Yeah, there's YouTube on there. We're building it up. Just got a new website going, so we're slowly adding all those things. But yeah, we're not stopping. We got lots of songs, lots of shows to brag about.
All right. I think you have a lot to look forward to then. I'm pretty excited about it.
Yeah, I hope you guys have us back for like a show next time, official one.
For sure, 100%. We have, I can think of something really fun that we'd love to have you come and perform for. So that would be amazing. So guys, when we sign off, we always just say happy trails. So y'all ready? Okay, thanks for watching today. We'll see you next time. Happy trails.